how long can they sustainably continue to subsidize without impacting their capital account too much?
In the past, in times of very volatile energy prices, i.e. crude oil, South Korean government has tended to intervene in terms of subsidies or by asking these oil refining companies to try to put a cap on these fuel prices. And looking at the past cases, I would say that these direct or indirect subsidies would tend to last for several months. And this comes at a pretty crucial time for energy and for South Korea, which is a net importer and actually 100% importer of essentially all energy, including crude oil, gas, coal. I think it's quite meaningful and important that the government extends and provides these subsidies for the manufacturers and for the consumers.
Hmm. And Cindy, when we're hearing, you know, $100 per barrel calls out there for oil, just looking at South Korea's oil refiner stocks, such as S-Oil, they're actually down year to date. In fact, really tracking lower on a day like this as well. Just can you explain what the strategy should be here? Do we, you know, differentiate oil refining companies listed in South Korea versus net gas and some of the other industrial lubricant makers in the country?
Typically, in times of rising energy prices or crude oil prices, it tends to reflect rising demand. So typically, those early times of crude oil increasing is a good entry point for downstream companies like oil refineries or chemical companies. However, when oil prices rise to where they are right now, especially in a short period of time, it tends to actually squeeze profitability of these downstream companies. And that is why stocks like S-Oil and SK Innovation are not reacting positively to crude oil prices. And from my experience, I find that crude oil price of $50 to $60 is a comfort level for these refining companies to actually take advantage of rising demand and at the same time oil prices remaining stable, somewhat, you know, moderately stable. But once the energy prices breaks out of that band and rises to where it is right now, I don't think it is actually a healthy situation for these downstream companies.